So I guess for now we'll run it. Let's take a look what's in here while we're working our way up there. $7, $17 in total, $26. And an energy drink, which we don't need. Alright, so this wasn't a complete waste. We made a few bucks by coming up here. See, to me, I think this game's going to be a mixture of killing zombies, but surviving. I mean, that's always been the concept of zombies to me, is the survival aspect of the zombies. It's not just surviving the initial outbreak and learning how to combat against the zombies as much as it's going to be taking crates and walking with crates in your hand. That seems useful. Was it not letting me up there? There we go. Surviving afterwards and realizing what you gotta do to survive it. It's not going to be just the initial outbreak. It's going to be the details afterwards that are going to, for most people, be the bad thing. That's a nice little grimace on his face. They actually did a good job with that. So yeah, my reviews are pretty simple, guys. I like it. It's good for what it is. It's definitely a lot of fun. It's not my typical genre of gameplay, so it's taken me a while to get used to it, if you guys can't tell. Alright, come on. Come on, Afro Man. Where is it versus me? Straight ahead.
Something I can use.
Mr. Zombie, sir, can you leave these nice ladies alone and stuck in there? Because she didn't do anything to you. And I don't think I appreciate you trying to break in like that. It's definitely worth coming in here, simply for the amount of stuff we're getting out of here.
I'm so scared. I feel dizzy and a little nauseous. My heart is pounding, please. I haven't had anything to drink for quite a while. If you bring me some water,
You're lucky. I have water on me.
Oh. Thank God. Thank you. Whatever you can find. Oh, thank God. Thank you.
So what do I get? I get...
Oh, thank God.
50 XP.
Thank you.
That's it? Or do I get 50 XP a shot? I'm not sure. We'll eat some fruit.
I'm safe in here. The monsters can't
get me. Well, what do we got here?
Who are you? I'm Annie, and I'm looking for my teddy bear.
Mm-hmm.
I can't fall asleep without him, and I'm very tired. And those monsters keep knocking.
Mm-hmm.
Will you find my teddy bear?
Mm-hmm. Yes. I'll find your damn teddy bear. Okay, so either we have some post-traumatic stress syndrome issues here, or the girl's just not right in the head. I'm just not sure which. Lady, I already gave you 2 bottles of water. What's wrong with this chick? Lady, I gave you 2 bottles of water already. Okay, everybody down now? Everybody done trying to mess with me? We all done? Alright, I'm pretty sure I just finished a quest and just have to take it back. Yeah. So now, how do I get back all the way down to there? Okay. We should be pretty good here with the zombies, so I should be able to just book it and run. Get back my stamina. And now hopefully by the time we get back, that damn car is running. We'll find out briefly. More importantly though, we can get the moaning of the woman to stop, which was just annoying me. All in all, it is what it is. Look, the car is running. Get over here and get this woman healed more than anything.
We just saved a lot of lives, mate. Maybe even save hands. Thank you.
Sweet. That was easy. And we get another skill point. Let me see here. I almost went to that last slot just to have it. Because then we'll do pick locks. Yeah, let's do that. There, we have full backpack space supposedly now. We will go repair, and we'll see where we are. I'm thinking we're actually doing pretty good here so far today. Wow, the damaging stick definitely needed a repair. But we end up having more money than we need constantly. This is good. I don't know where my stamina is energy-wise, so let's down a bottle just to play it safe. Alright, Wayne. Let's talk for a minute here, buddy. I got stuff I want to sell you. Okay? Stuff I'm just not going to need. Okay, and it's just... Let's talk here. It's just taking up my spot. It's just taking up room. So I'll tell you what. I will sell you some stuff if you agree to buy it from me. I think we'll sell the... No. That's the one we want. But which one does more damage? Alright, we'll put the diving knife and that up there. We'll get rid of the rusty pipe. The only thing really worth a damn down here are the engine parts and that, and I don't want to sell that yet. Everything else just looks like it's junk. Oh, the phones. You know what? Dude, you can have the phones. Because they're going to be useless to me. Magnets I want to keep. Yeah, everything else I want to keep. Definitely gave me some money here. So let's take a look here now. I want to put that bad boy right there. This pipe can go up here. Here. You know what? Let's redo this. Damaging stick is the most damaging weapon I have right now, followed by the cleaver and the diving knife. At that point, the pipe is my next, followed by the flimsy stick, followed by the baton. And voila. Now we can set up our next quest here. Which will be pretty much the one I picked there, my precious, which is fine. And now I have all of my weapons set up here. And we have the most damaging one set up with the other two right there. But if that diving knife does that much damage, I want to go upgrade it right now. So we're going to upgrade our Spitful diving knife the whole way. And now it does 44 plus 19, 63, or 63. So these two now match. And this one does 55. So they're all pretty even, but I definitely have some definitely options here, which is good. It's a good way to start. But let's go take a last look here at Wayne, because Wayne had stuff to buy. Wayne's most damaging item in his selection right now is the machete. The machete only costs $289, but it does a ton of damage, which is good. It doesn't really have a whole lot else, but that's good. Now, what is this cup thing here? Oh, it's a reward I never picked up. Well, that's good. Now, where'd she wander off to?
Good in here.
I don't know where she wandered off to. She's not dead.